$20 in gas and drive the 2 hours and be home in my own bed. Come back in the morning. We're gonna bring back top 8. Because in the top 8 are guaranteed 150, so it makes it worth them coming back, basically. The 9th through 12th is only $75. By the time you 2 days, and you paid $65 to get in, you don't even break even. You end up losing money. And you won $10 in the tournament, basically, you still lose money. So they'll get to the top 8. And they'll run the top 8 on this side when they start that over there.
What table do they play? They're playing right here.
I thought they were going to put him on 7. Oh, he put Tommy and Kaylee on. That's right. I remember now. Kaylee's dad, our granddad's watching.
That's her granddad?
Her granddad's watching on.
Oh, I got it.
And wanted to see the match between her and Tom.
Oh, I got
doing okay? Is he still doing okay?
Thank you. Stealing a seat at Steven's girl for a minute. What's up, girl? She win?
Yeah. But it's early.
It is early. Haley or Kylie? On the winter side.
Yep.
Plays good. Swung at the cue ball like real hard and it hit both titties. He hit it so hard it hit both titties and then go three rails. No, and then go three rails. Seriously. And then come out like rose. She ready to play some yet?
I'm not playing tonight.
I don't take anything so serious. I'm just joking. Did you get the score somewhere?
No. I was playing until I wasn't doing scoring. And then when I got done, I was too lazy to do it.
Well, we appreciate your honesty.
Thank you. Chevrolet, Water, Rock, Rock.
Thank you.
Table. Anthony Fisher, Chris Gentile, table one.
Thank you.
Diamonds that he was at, I didn't leave there till 6:30 in the morning. It was freaking daylight. I was still driving home. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me.
That's pretty unheard of for a tournament.
Well, they ran 64 all in one night.
Maybe that's what they did in Jacksonville. And they got five. So it makes sense, I guess.
Yeah.
And that was at Parkhouse, so there's a ton of tables.
Yeah, this was at Diamonds in Cape Coral.
Oh, there's a ton of tables.
Yeah, there's a good amount, but still, it was fucking crazy. I was like, oh my god, really? Yeah, they kicked everybody out that wasn't in the tournament anymore, locked the door. We were all just hanging out waiting for everybody to get done.
Yeah, some of those tournaments are grind, man.
That's where Anthony beat Tommy.
Yeah. I mean, he's done that plenty of times.
Oh, yeah.
I'm 1-1 against Tommy now.
$15-$30, dude. Only selling 50 tickets too, so you got good odds. Yeah, you get, if you buy 2 tickets, 2 in 50 chance, it's pretty good odds.
Not bad for a raffle. No. I wouldn't say good odds, but I would.
For a raffle, I'm saying. Most raffles you go into are 100-200 tickets. Yeah, so you got, exactly, you got it. Even with 25, you still don't win, you know what I'm saying?
I'm sorry, I'm a little drunk and I thought you were sober.
Oh, you're good, man.
You look exactly like another guy that hangs on me.
Yep. But yeah, most rappers, you gotta buy 25, 30 tickets to even stand a chance to win something.
Yep, that's why I usually don't do them.
Yeah.
I don't really take gambles like that very often. I'm not much like a scratch-off person.
That's why I'm running them the way I am with the low numbers, because that's what entices me to get them. I'm not big on raffles, but it entices me to get them because there's not very many tickets being sold, so you got a better chance of winning. So I figure, hey, why not? If I'm gonna get in a raffle, I might as well get in that raffle.
With some decent odds,
exactly.
Rather than like real low.
Exactly.
I feel you.
But yeah, the majority of the time I'm like you, I don't even bother with it, period.
Yeah, man. Still, like,
two for 50 is better odds, but still bad.
Yeah.
For $30, that's really, you know, $30. You know,
oh yeah.
Like, I know they're not chance. I don't like $30 to take a 2 for 50 chance, to be honest with you. That's just not me.
For $1,000 custom cue.
But yeah, you're making out. That's true though. $2.50 to make 500% on your money. Yeah.
You're getting $1,000 cue for $30. 15 if you buy one and win.
Man, I think that, what is it?
Tony Saar. It's a sweet ass cue. I was messing with my boy. I had bought it and told him, said something about it coming up missing. I said, yeah, this one might just coming up missing. I might not raffle this one. It might just disappear or something. End up in my pool case. Shit, I don't shoot good enough to own no damn $1,000 cue.
Hey man, if you're just, you can just do it for profitable reasons, you know what I mean? Like, you don't gotta play with it. But dude, fuck that. What do you mean you don't play good enough? Anybody, that's dumb. It's a dumb way of looking at it.
Nah.
You can play with $1,000 cue, I can play with $1,000 cue. I don't give a fuck how you play.
You don't I can play
with a $13 cue and win world championships.
That's what I'm saying. That's so, why I shouldn't even.
Who gives a fuck about the price of the cue?
I should
sell that shit and play with the cue I have now because I got a feel for that cue.
That's what I'm saying. I'd get a way cheaper cue. Yeah, there ain't no point in me keeping $1,000 cue. I don't need it.
Yeah, I play with the first cue I ever bought. You know what I'm saying? I buy new shafts for it if I need to. But
exactly.
I play with the same butt.
Yep.
I spent a lot on my first one because it was motivation. Like, get good enough to pay off.
Yeah, but you got it for the rest of your life now, yeah. You know, so now you can keep that shit, you know, you can start it out with something decent, you know what I'm saying?
Like, I just wanted one I would like and, you know, want to eat
it. And so. Stick with for rest, like, forever, you know what I'm saying? What's the point of adjusting to new shit, you know what I mean? I tried switching there for a while. One time I switched to my grandfather's original Palmer, fucking beautiful, badass cue. Like, I tried playing with it for a while, and like 6 months, but I felt like kind of like brought my game down a little bit. I switched back, and I'm like, yeah, I had more confidence again.
You get comfortable.
I tried, but dude, yeah, it's just so different. You know what I mean? Like, that feel, man.
Yeah, like you said, once you get comfortable with it,
yeah,
with the feel with something, it's just not the same.
Exactly. Like, I'd be absolutely fucking devastated. Like, some of these guys get their fucking keys stolen and shit, man. Like, oh, man. That'd be heartbreaking.
Yeah.
I have a Predator BK2 brake stick. Yeah, fucking, like, 4 years, 5 years, got stolen fast enough.
That place is kind of brutal, dude. Every time I ever went there, I went with Kim Dyer a couple times, and he'd always have a couple hundred. I'd have a couple hundred, but that's all I'd bring. I'd never walk in there with more than like $200.
It's in Tampa.
It closed down.
Yeah, it's
going for action
now. Play Jimmy Red.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's who Kim used to play at One Pocket. But yeah, dude, and them guys, they'd always want a side man.
They kind of gang up on you.
Yeah, dude, I'm
which is kind of great in a way, but you gotta fade them. They'll get in your head big time, dude. They'll sit there on the sidelines and just fucking talk their asses off.
Oh
dude,
yeah.
Dude, I mean, I've been kind of in a trap in that situation before where they kind of like, we'll start shit with you, you know what I'm saying? Just fucking get in your head, dude. I was there, man. I kind of got stressed up a little bit. Like, I was giving up a lot of weight. I mean, I got these fucking guys on the sideline, like, kind of barking at me, like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It was just a bad situation.
That's exactly how I felt that night. I was like, damn, dude, I'm looking at Kim going, I want you to win, but I don't want you to win a whole bunch of money because we got to walk out of this place.
Yeah,
go out into that parking lot.
Yeah, you know
what I'm saying?
Help you with the right people.
Exactly. That's why I'm like, man, I don't like this at all.
Yeah.
I'm not about this.
Were you with that big fat black dude in there one time? Like, what happened to you? Or?
No.
I almost got in the fucking big fat like, wrestling match.
I was gonna say that the Bill Rucker got smart.
Yeah. Well, I don't care how heavy you are. He ain't got speed. He ain't got fucking reflex. He ain't know what's coming. He's good.
No, you could take him down in less than a minute.
He knows. He knew that. Technique over strength.
Oh, yeah, it'll always prevail. Unless it's just too astronomically of a difference.
Right,
then it's
this awesome. Dude's like fat and out of shape.
Yeah.
I can get behind him.
And what did he have? What do you have on you? Maybe twice your weight at most.
Dude, my uncle weighs 300+.
That's what I'm saying.
And he had wrestling experience, and I still took him down like nothing. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying. He was at most twice your weight.
Right, and he's not even an athlete.
Yeah. He'd have to be over like three times your weight to make it a problem for you, because then you're dealing with just the bolt. He could just, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and it'd be tough, you know?
Yeah. I'd still know how to work at the knees and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I made a little money on that shit, man. But CM's the one time we were talking about, yeah, that dude was like 200, but we kind of got to talking shit a little bit. We did like 20 of takedown right at CM's place, like between the tables and shit, dude. I made like, made $80 off this dude. Took him down like four times in like 2 minutes.
That's funny.
Wrestling accident on the wall.
Right. I've heard shit about you wrestling and stuff, but I've never seen any of it or...
Yeah, it's happened pretty, like, a lot of, like, I get fucked up and shit, and guys will start shit, you know?
Yeah.
It just gets a little out of here, it's all fun,
though. Oh, yeah. He's on the hill.
Thank you.
car payment and stuff? Yeah, I do. He likes the company, so he doesn't mind. He's the one that wanted me to stay with him.
Oh, really?
Yeah, which is really nice because we've never had a good relationship, and like, I was surprised. Yeah, so it's kind of surprising he wanted to stay with him, but we're working things out now. And it's good now.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it's nice.
I do that sometimes. I said, yeah, you remember the Seminole Pro Tour when it was $500 buy-in and I shot you full of holes? Oh, I do that sometimes. I said, no, I really said, this is what I really said. I said, I let you win all the little tournaments.
Yeah. Bullshit or what?
No, I said, I let you win all the little tournaments and I win the big ones. Like, the big money buy-in. So I was saying, you don't get down for the cheddar, like, in a roundabout way, but it was real friendly. Like, it wasn't like, negative. If you can tell somebody how you feel.
You should have said the first thing.
Yeah, well, yeah. I think it was around. I'm a little blazed.
A little blazed, yeah. You ready? You done?
Yeah, take one.
Yeah, I'm ready.